Let's take a look at how you can optimize queries in ClickHouse using projections. What is a projection? Well, a projection is kind of like a materialized view. If you're familiar with that concept where you create a separate table and maybe you sort the data in a different way because you only get one primary key for a merge tree table in ClickHouse. But sometimes you wish, man, I wish I could sort my data a different way so I could take advantage of skipping granules and all the benefits of having the sort order and the primary key be that way. And so projections allow you to do that. They store the data in multiple ways. Just like you might use a materialized view to keep a running total or a running average or something, the pre-aggregated values. You can do that with a projection as well. What's interesting about projections is instead of storing it in a separate table that you create like a materialized view, with a projection, you don't create a separate table. ClickHouse creates kind of a hidden anonymous table behind the scenes for you. And it actually stores the data in a subfolder of the part folder. Every projection is a part level entity. It only is a projection of the rows in a part. So each part has its own projection folder. So why use it? Why not just use a materialized view? I mean, you certainly can use a materialized view, but sort of the benefit is if you have a projection, you don't have to have these different tables with these different schemas. You don't have to know ahead of time, oh, do I have a materialized view? And what does that materialized view do? And is there a benefit? You kind of have to know those things about your materialized views. With a projection, you just have one table, one schema, you write the query, and you let ClickHouse decide. Is the projection going to save me from skipping a bunch of rows or something? Well, that's what ClickHouse does at query time. It figures out, is there a projection for this table that's going to make this query run faster? And if it finds one, it'll use that projection. So let's see how they work. Let's look at an example. So I have this table called UK price paid. And if we look at how the table was created, I'm interested in the primary key. It looks like the primary key is postcode 1, postcode 2, and then address 1 and address 2. If you're interested, this data set is in the doc. If you go to the documentation, look at example data sets, you'll see it's the UK property prices data set. So it's a pretty interesting data set. It's all this property that was sold in the United Kingdom. And so it looks like we have 28 million and a half rows roughly. And if I want to do something like find the average price of property sold where postcode 1 is a value, postcode 2 is provided as well. Those are the first two columns in the primary key. And you'll notice that it only has to read exactly one granule. I mean, that's the perfect scenario in ClickHouse. Your data is nicely sorted. ClickHouse only has to read one granule. And I have another query that I already wrote. It's the exact same query as above, but here I'm going to filter on the town column. Now the town column is not in the primary key. And notice in the result, I mean, the result is still very fast, but it had to read 28 million rows, which is the entire data set. So the primary key didn't help at all in this particular query because town is not a part of the primary key. So all the granules had to be read. Now you can create a projection when you create the table in the original table creation statement. But since my table didn't have a projection, I'm going to add one. So I'm going to alter the UK price paid table. And I'm going to add a projection. And you can call it whatever you want. I'm just going to call it the town sort projection. That's very specific, but that's what I'm doing. I'm going to sort by town. And it's going to be the result of a query. So I'm going to select, and I could select star if I wanted to, but just to demonstrate that I can pick the columns that I want in my projection, I'll just pick a handful of columns. I'll pick the town, the price of the property, the date it was sold, the street that it's on, and the locality, whatever that value is. And I'm going to order by town. That's the key. That's what makes this unique, is the fact that I'm ordering by town. Now that happens right away. And if I go back up and run this query, you're going to find out that it read all 28 million rows. Well, that's because I defined the projection, but the projection doesn't get materialized right away. If I was inserting data rapidly, the new parts would have this projection, but none of the existing parts do. And I have to wait for a merge, but I can force that. So I can do an alter table, UK price paid. And I'm going to materialize the projection, town sort projection. Now, this can take a minute. The query came back right away, but it's an asynchronous mutation. You can actually see this happening in the mutations. But look what happens when I run this query. And we'll see if it's happening quickly. Well, it still hasn't created the projection yet. Notice that read all 28 million rows. So we'll just wait a bit longer. Let me try it again. Ah, and there you can see it only read 2.1 million rows or 2,187,264. That's a multiple of 8,192. It's exactly 267 granules. So instead of reading thousands and thousands of granules, it only had to read a couple hundred granules. And if you want to see if your projection's getting used or not, you can add an explain to the front of your query. And then if you look at the result, forget about this word projection. That's really got nothing to do with the projection you just defined. But if I scroll down, I can see read from merge tree, and there I can see town sort projection. So that tells me that my projection was used in this query. And I have one more example that I want to show you, and this one I already typed up. I'm just going to run this query. This finds the maximum price of the properties in London over the whole data set. And you can see that it only had to read the 2.1 million rows because we have that nice projection. But what I want to do is, I mean, a maximum price, that's just one value. That's something that's easy to keep track. If we wanted to do that for every town in this data set, the projection can be an aggregation. So here I picked maximum price from the table and then I grouped it by town. So every town is going to have its maximum price saved. So let me define this projection. And again, this happens at the part level. So now inside every part, we're going to have the maximum price of every town. That didn't happen right away, so we'll have to materialize the projection just like we did before. That's a mutation. Check the system.mutations table to see when that particular mutation is going to be done, and then you'll know your projection is materialized. And now when I run this query to find the maximum price, well, it only had to read 1,172 rows. Well, that's probably how many towns there are in this particular data set. And so this projection only stores a small amount of data, but it's super quick, like it's super fast how it works. And again, if you want to see the explain command, it's nice to see that your projection is being used. Obviously it's being used by the number of rows that came back, but there you can see it in the explain statement as well. And that's how you define a projection in ClickHouse. Be sure to check the docs for more information and be sure to check out learn.clickhouse.com, where we also have more content and information on projections.